Good afternoon, viewers. You're welcome to Group 10 Discussion Forum. And I remain your favorite host, Eromasele Ebiago. And with me are resource persons, and we're going to be discussing on a particular issue today affecting our society, and that is access and agenda setting theory. With me, starting from the right, is
AKBZ for my goodness.
Precious Chimeni Ikoa.
Ekihana Chupa. Hope Olilaya.
As you can see, we have beautiful ladies and a gentleman. Alright, I want to start with Eke Hana. Hana, what do you think about access theory?
Well, the access theory is a theory. It is a sub-theory of the libertarian theory. And it's a theory that talks about ensuring that the masses be granted full access to the media. For example, they should be allowed to air their view. Let them just say whatever they think. And the owners of the newspapers or the editors should allow them to say whatever they think about a particular issue without restricting them. This is irrespective of the facts or from whether the newspaper, editor, whatever, are in support of the view of these masses. They should be allowed the access to say whatever their view or their opinion is about a particular issue affecting the society.
Wow, what a take from Hannah right there. So what do you also have to say about this access theory?
Okay. Access theory has to do with the opinions of the masses, where the masses are allowed to air their views, to give their own opinion on a particular government or what they think should affect them personally. These ideas they made, they are allowed to mediate them, they are allowed to say whatever they wish to see and how they feel about them. The government and the policy they need.
Okay.
Let me say something. I was totally told to their line of thought, because I remember reading the role that libertarian theory in the olden days about Thomas Jefferson and others, where they gave the masses freedom to end their view. The masses took opportunity of that, and then they went further to analyze and give unnecessary and bad judgment on the government. Oh. And that is the main reason why the social responsibility theory was made. If the masses are given the total freedom to air their view, I tell you, there will be a kind of more sycophant in the administration of things. The masses should not be given total freedom. The editors are there. Though I know there is a biased judgment when the editors are doing their work, breaking on their own personal experience to their work. But I feel that if these masses should be given this total freedom, it will be a good sign for us. Whereas the mass media are there as a watchdog of the society, but no, the editors should be there to edit the work. It should not really be that they should. No, I don't totally concur to that fact.
Wow. So do you think the masses should be given absolute freedom, absolute access to the media?
And I said they should be given freedom to both to an extent. If they want to say something, or particular stuff about the president, about the government, there should be people that they watchdog. It is the editors that will edit what they have to say, because you can't just come up and maybe accuse the president and people accept what you say. There should be people that will edit your news, edit what you have to say before they air it out to the audience.
So that means there's been a limit to this to the public accessing the media. Wow. And don't forget, viewers, you can be part of the show, and the number to call is 0810-944-8510. I take it again, 0810-944-8510. Okay, we have a call. I think we should take this. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, what's your name and where are you calling us from? Okay, Mr. Manasseh from Port Harcourt, what's your pick on this issue, access theory? Should the public be given the access to access the media house whenever they like and air their opinion? Okay. All right, so in one word, can you just summarize the access theory? Okay, do up to call us, Mr. Manasseh. All right, you heard it all from him. He said they should be limited too. But it's all right. So that brings us to where we take our first break, and when we come back, we'll discuss on the other issue, the agenda setting theory, and how it affects the Nigerian system and the nation as a whole. All right. Welcome back. We're talking about the agenda setting theory, and Mr. Precious has been giving us his view, and everybody has been giving us their own views. And I presume we're having much calls, and we couldn't take them because of time factor. And time is never our friend when it comes to shows like this. But before we go, I would like Mr. Precious to summarize the access theory and the agenda setting theory in one sentence, in a very short sentence, as in how they both tally along.
I don't think I can really point out a relationship between the access theory and the agenda setting theory in just a sentence, but let me see what I can do. The media has a watchdog of the government. You say something concerning the government, and then when they are done with their news and broadcasts and everything, they will not pronounce cast it to me.
Okay, sorry, let's take this last call. Hello. Yeah, good afternoon. What's your name and where are you calling us from? Okay, Prince from Rumokuta. What's your take on this agenda setting theory? So Faith, do you think this theory should be adopted by Nigeria?
Reflect on that thing, and they'll pin down something. They'll definitely, that's consuming or perceiving that same information from masses. We prompt them to write something based on what they have already perceived from the media.
All right, thanks for joining us on the show. It was nice having you guys. Today we'll have to draw the curtain. And see you next time, same station next week. Bye bye.